Hello, boys and girls. It's Miss Belinda. I am here in the first to third grade classroom here at St. Thomas's Episcopal Church in Newark, Delaware. Thank you for joining me for another Sunday school lesson. Remember that Easter is a time of celebration, that time that we celebrate, that Jesus died, but God made him alive again. So, we'll be telling a story today about Jesus and his friends after he was resurrected. You're getting ready song. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God. Remember that when we sing that song, it's time to get ready. That means that our eyes are watching, our ears are listening, and our hands and feet are tucked in close so that we can leave the story to be told. Jesus died and was buried in the tomb. This was Jesus who had said and done such wonderful things. Jesus died, but God made him alive again. Some of Jesus' friends had seen an angel who told them that Jesus was alive. Others ran and found the tomb empty. One of the women had seen Jesus. He called her by name, and she knew the sound of his voice. Many of Jesus' friends wondered what had really happened. This is a road to a city called Emmaus. On the same day that Mary saw Jesus, that same day that Peter and John ran to the empty tomb to see what had happened, on that same day, two of Jesus' friends walked on the road to Emmaus. Another person joined them, but the friends did not know who he was. When he took the bread, blessed it, broke it, and gave it to them, the friends knew it was Jesus. Jesus was alive. But Jesus went away. The friends hurried back to Jerusalem to tell Jesus' other friends what had happened. On that same day, Jesus' friends had gathered in the upper room.
as they talked, suddenly Jesus was with them. He showed them his hands and side. He asked for something to eat. He talked with the disciples. Then suddenly, Jesus went away. The next Sunday, Thomas was with the friends. Suddenly, Jesus came again. He said, "Peace be with you." Thomas believed when he saw Jesus. He did not need to touch him. And again, Jesus left suddenly. Jesus' friends must have spent a lot of time talking about all that had happened, about the amazing things Jesus did, and the wonderful things that he said. One day, Peter said, "I'm going fishing." James, John, Thomas, and three other friends said, "We'll go with you." They walked a long way, all the way up Lake Galilee, where they had lived and fished before they met Jesus. Fished, but caught nothing. In the morning, someone on the shore called, "Friends, have you any fish?" "No," they answered. "Then put your nets on the right side of the boat," called the person from the shore. Seven friends put their nets on the right side of the boat. The net became full of fish. Then the seven friends knew the person on the shore was Jesus. When the seven friends counted the fish, there were 153, but the net wasn't broken. Bread for breakfast. When the friends joined Jesus, he invited them to eat. He took the bread and fish and gave them to his friends to eat. After breakfast, Jesus had some special words for Peter. Jesus told him, "Feed my sheep." He also told him, "Follow me." I wonder how Jesus' friends felt when they saw him again. I wonder how it felt to fish all night and not to catch anything. Side of the boat and to catch so many fish. I wonder how the disciples felt when they knew that it was Jesus on the shore. I wonder how it felt to eat that breakfast that Jesus had prepared. I wonder how Peter felt to hear the special words that Jesus spoke to him. wonder how it felt to be so close to Jesus in his new beginning after his resurrection. Pray together. First, let's say the Children's Creed. I believe in God above. I believe in Jesus' love. I believe His Spirit too comes to show us what to do. I believe that kind and loving, Lord, like Thee. Now, let's say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be Thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now it's time for our own personal prayers. This is the time when we can pray for anything we want. We can pray for things that we're thankful for, things that we're sad about, scared about, maybe things that we need, or maybe things that someone else needs. Anything we want to pray about, God is listening. Let us pray. Lord, I thank you for this day. I thank you for each and every child in our Sunday school program, each and every child and grown-up who's watching our video. I pray for all the families in our church. I pray for all the families in our community. I pray for the nurses and the doctors and the people who are working in the grocery store to make sure that we have food during this time. Thank you, God, for sending Jesus to show us the way, to be our friend. I thank you, God, for giving all of us friends who we can rely on. I thank you especially for my family. And I thank you, Lord, for all the blessings that you've given us. I especially thank you today for helping Josh and Mariah to finish up their semesters at school. I thank you for keeping them safe and healthy. Amen. All right, your turn. Tell someone in your house that something that you'd like to pray for. Lord, we thank you for hearing all of our prayers, the ones that we said out loud and the ones that we said in our hearts. We thank you for always blessing us with your presence in our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, one more thing. We couldn't do our response together today, but I wanted to share with you the coloring sheet that I did this morning to go with our story. And hopefully you'll have fun coloring something to go with the story, or I'm sure your family, you and your family will find something cool to do together to respond. Here's my picture. had to say goodbye. So we'll sing our blessing song. Go now in peace. Go now in peace.